Don't shoot him! We need him alive!
Oh, goddammit, I said hands!
All the dead people outside, Jim.
I can't. Hey, hold on for a second.
Sorry.
So, it's gotta be it.
Does it? Burn, you little bastards. Good night.
Thank you.
This will work. No, I just gotta jimmy that door. That did it.
Boozer, it's Deacon. Come back. Lost Lake Camp. Is anyone there?
Deke, is that you?
Yeah, Boozer, it's me.
Hey, it is good to hear from you, brother.
Good to hear from you, too. Listen, I got a lot of time. The research facility that Sarah used to work at, the one near Iron Butte, the one near the Ripper, you know the one that I'm talking about, right? So listen, there's food here. Lots of food, corn, so tell Ricky, tell Iron Mytone to send someone.
Wait, you found her? What, you found Sarah?
Yeah, I found her. It was, man, I found her.
That is awesome, Dick! When are you bringing her back? What, to Lost Lake?
No, I'm not gonna get into that right now. Boozer. Lost Lake Camp, come in. Ah, damn it.
Lost Lake, come in.
Ricky. Okay, good. Listen up.
Deke?
Yeah, it's me. Listen, there's a...
I don't think we'd hear from you again. Iron Mike said you weren't coming back.
Look, I don't have a lot of time. Listen, there's this...
Did you find her?
Yeah, I found her. Ricky?
I'm glad, Deke. You were right. We made it. I'm glad she did, too. Deke?
Yeah, okay, listen, there's this farm, okay? There's power. It's got electrical fences.
Electric fences, okay.
And if you come here, ask Boozer. It's where Sarah used to work by Iron Butte. He's gonna know the place. You come over here, you're gonna find food. You're gonna find lots of food.
Okay.
Oh, how's he doing?
Good. You'll never believe who Iron Mike made head of security.
Are you kidding? Wow, that's great. Could you tell... You know what? Listen, I gotta go, Ricky. But, you know what? Wait a second. That thing you said about, lighting a candle? I think maybe you were right.
I know. Ricky out.
St. John, this is Curry. Where are you? One of my men reported that you went through his checkpoint at the Teelson Pass.
Yeah, Captain. There's a research facility in Iron Butte. It's like Sarah, Lieutenant Whitaker said, there's an important piece of equipment that she needed. And this was where... And this was the only place that she could get it.
She's not answering her radio. The Colonel wants to know why you're not back yet.
Tell him we're on our way.
The Colonel wants to speak to you.
Sorry, Captain, you're...
Did you talk to him? To Boozer?
Yeah. Yeah, I told him that you're fine and we're fine and that I had to get moving because we have to try to make it over the pass before the weather turns.
What do you think?
I don't know. It doesn't look good. But it's worth a try, so let's get moving.
It's clear. Are you gonna come out and eat something?
Soaking wet. Excuse me. God, I never thought I'd get warm again. Did you want to eat something, or?
Yeah.
Yeah. God, I'm not even hungry.
Yeah, neither am I. You cold? Come here.
Thank you. Hey there.
What's up with you?
St. John, come in.
This is Corporal St. John. What's up, Captain?
I need you to head back to command. Stat. Meet me at the infirmary.
The infirmary? What's wrong?
There's been an incident.
I'm on my way. Okay, what the hell? Lieutenant Whitaker, are you there? Sarah? Come in, Sarah! God damn it.
Move along, buddy, move along.
A few weeks back, we were riding west along the old Belknap Road.
Go, go.
Hey, what's going on? Captain?
Dr. Jimenez has been murdered. Son of a bitch.
Jesus Christ.
Slit his throat from here to
Where's
here.
Where's Taylor? Did Taylor see anything?
All the narcotics in the camp are gone.
Taylor.
This one's on me. I assigned him to the infirmary.
No, no, that's not what I'm saying. I'm saying Taylor was a junkie.
You knew? It doesn't matter.
This day, as the sun sets on this island, it also sets on the life of a great man, Captain Arturo Jimenez. Doc, to many of you, is gone. Taken from us on the eve of our great victory, Captain Jimenez was murdered, slaughtered, his life ripped from him. His blood, even now, soaks the tent where he toiled, hour after hour, tending our sick, our injured, our wounded. The great tragedy here is not that a good man needlessly lost his life, though for that I am indeed very sorry. The great tragedy here is that he could not be replaced. Dr. Jimenez was the only trained physician in our ranks, perhaps in all the world. My eyes have been opened. I see now the great mistake we have made. We have filled our ark with books and seeds and discs. Medical journals, medical books, and encyclopedia we have in spades. But who now, when this terrible war is over, will teach us how to use them? Journals can be replaced. replaced. Books and encyclopedia can be replaced. Dr. Jimenez, our only doctor, cannot be replaced. I go now to grieve in private. I suggest you do the same. Company dismissed.
Hey, what are you doing here?
Corporal Deacon St. John.
Sarge, good to see you.
Okay, yeah. Every little bit helps, yeah? Oh, yeah. Upgrade the hell out of that thing, right? Okay, now that's more like it. Oh, big spender. Yeah, gonna make me a quadrillionaire, right? Credit burning a hole in your man purse or what? There you go. Okay, now that's more like it. Oh, big spender. Yeah, gonna make me a quadrillionaire, right? Huh? Oh, okay. See ya, Corporal.
Corporal, nice to see you.
Hey, Sergeant. Still breathing, I see.
Okay, then. Corporal, you come back in one piece, all right?
Deke, Corporal in command.
Hey, Sarge. How's life?
Move along.
Captain Curry, come in. Corporal St. John to Captain Curry.
This is Curry.
Hey, I'm gonna go after Taylor.
Several patrols have already been sent out. The Colonel's furious.
Yeah, I'll bet. The doc was a good guy.
Captain Jimenez was the only doctor we had.
Look, Taylor mentioned something about heading up to the ski lodge. I'm gonna go there and see if I can find him.
Radio me if you do. And Corporal, the Colonel wants Taylor alive.
Yeah. Copy that. St. John out.
St. John, I need to see you. I'll be at the Diamond Lake Outpost.
Copy that. I'll be there as soon as I can.
Security Council. Think about it. Nero's got a clear hand in this, but they need a lot of help to start this war. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Who knows, Cope, maybe you're right for a change. If you had any idea what they were cooking up inside Cloverdale in your goddamn backyard, you'd have a heart attack.
St. John, are you there? I need you to report to me at command at your convenience.
Colonel, of course, sir. St. John out.
Scrap.
I never did finish burning out this nesting zone.
Bounties.
Thank you.
There we go. Good night. Use this. Renegade Patrol. God damn it. What the hell happened here? Oh, no. I wonder if they left anything worth the effort. Yeah. use this. Nothing like scrap. Use this.
St. John, you there?
Yeah, Weaver. I'm here.
Hey, call the general. Listen, I never said thank you for helping me out of me.
And look, I'm just following orders.
Well, I'm gonna thank you anyway. I really appreciate you going out and shit, risking your neck for me. And dude, this napalm shit's almost good to go. We're gonna need you to help test it pretty soon.
Yeah, sure, Weaver. Jim. Yeah, I'll be around.
Taylor, what the hell are you doing out here? This is it. Okay, let's see. What's going on here? There you are. I gotta find a way inside.
What's up? Don't let him. We can do this.
Okay.
What was that? What's up?
Something's out there. He's out there.
Look out! Kill him!
Thank you.
Taylor. It's Deacon St. John. How we doing, Taylor?
That fucked up, man. I didn't mean to kill him, man. He wasn't supposed to be there. Doc was a good guy, man. He fucking helped me. He helped me.
Come on, get up.
No. I don't want to hang, man. I don't want to hang. I don't want to hang. I don't want
to. Hey, listen to me, Taylor. Taylor.
You kick and you kick and you shit yourself. All those fucks standing at attention. And they're laughing at you. They're laughing at you. I don't want to. I don't want to. Please. Don't let them hang me.
St. John.
In here.
Overdose.
God damn it. Bring the body outside. I don't care what a man's done. We never leave him for the freaks. I can tell you right now, the Colonel's not going to be happy about this.
Well,
when we found him, he was already dead. Overdosed.
We recovered most of the drugs, not all.
As if the world hasn't seen enough corruption and decay. As if the world isn't already filled to overflowing with mindless, soulless creatures. Take these to the infirmary. And this time, assign someone who isn't a goddamn junkie.
Yes, sir.